Budgetdiva Magazine and she will give the talk in English.
Okay. Correct me if I'm wrong. Okay. I'm Emmy. I am working from home, not because I originally choose to work from home, but from a life-changing event. I needed to work from home for a while. And then I started to work for a project as a receptionist in a very large factory who reorganized everything and moved to Hungary. That's why a lot of people from a certain age, above 40, 50 years, were fired after 25, 30 years of duty in the factory. And they are all panicking about what to do next, because finding a job is very difficult if you did 25 years or so, the same stuff day in, day out. And so then I looked at myself at the situation that I needed to work from home for a while. And then I thought, well, if I can do this, the other people can do that also, but they need to know that it is possible that you don't have to lick on envelopes all day to work from home. That is a way of thinking. A lot of people from a certain generation still think you need to do something like putting on stamps on envelopes or something like that. That's not true. Or putting caps on pencils or something like that. That's not the point anymore. So I decided to concentrate myself to learn people to work from home with the computer online to save to earn money online. I am a certified financial advisor. I am a certified investment advisor and certified advisor, but I also invest for other people with portfolios. And there is a statement that that mainly women are very afraid of investing their money on stock markets and that sort of things. I also mine my own cryptocurrency. I'm a cryptocurrency miner. That's also something I do at home in the yard, in the barn. A lot of people think that it's a man world, but it's not necessarily a man world. It can be done by women also. You have to just educate yourself in it and think very logic. It's logic material. It's not higher science, as a lot of people think it is. So that's my mission, to teach people how they can earn money from home. If you have a computer, if you have a WordPress site, that's my favorite site, of course, otherwise I wasn't here. You can build a site in 1 hour, even if you never did something. A WordPress site from one page, just to offer your services in a very very fast way, it's doable. Maybe 2 pages, it's doable. But I want to talk about now, because this not only women above 14 who are sitting here, is the mindset and discipline you need to work from home, because it is not easy. There's always someone at the door who ring and say, "I saw your car. I thought she's home. Let's have a cup of coffee." Or your partner, "Oh, I'm so very bored. Come, let's go shopping." That sort of things. Now I have a little traffic light on my door post. Green, come in, I'm free. Orange is a little bit tricky. You really need to need something from me. I don't know if it's safe. Good. Red is only if you need some CPR. Don't bother to come in. But it is for a lot of people very difficult to have that discipline to go to work. So you have to have a routine. My routine is get out of bed at 6, meditate, do my jogging or running for 1 hour, about 10 kilometers. 1 hour and quarter, then shower, and then go to work till about 12 o'clock. It's not everybody needs to go out at 6 in the morning, of course, but it's my routine, because if I do it that way, then I know for sure that I'm ready at 1 o'clock, and then I have my free time. I can do what I want. My husband also works at home. He stays up, he comes out of bed at 9, and his room is different from mine. But at 8 o'clock in the evening, every device in the house is out. The PCs, the telephones, everything is out. Only the home phone is there for emergencies from the family. It's very important for you to realize that you need that sort of discipline, because otherwise you are 18 hours a day working in your office behind your screen, and you are not that productive as you want to be if you are sitting that much amount of time. The mindset you need also is to be very clear to your family and friends that you are working. You are not in a home to stay out of the street. You are working at home to earn money. So be very clear when the visiting hours are. In my home, is nobody welcome between 6 o'clock in the morning and 1 o'clock in the afternoon. But it's very important to do that for yourself. It's very difficult to say it to your friends and family, but it is very important to do so. Then you can also, we are entrepreneurs, but there also are a lot of people I know who work from home with contracts for companies. They need a virtual assistant. They need someone to pick up the phone. They need to have some administration tasks ready. They need to fill their agendas. All that sort of things can be done by working at home by contracts. But if you make a contract, always make sure that you have a legal person look at the contract, because it's different from working in an office for a company as when you work from home. I have two websites myself, with Jet Diva magazine, and it's very successful. I started a new one, 50 plus experience for the males who wants to work from home and have advice in personal finance. That means that it's a lot of work, but if I one more time here, someone say, I am a coach to make sure you can earn a lot of money from working with your passion, I think I'm going to scream, because it's okay to make your passion work, but it's not okay to say within 3 months you have 10,000 euros a month, because that is myth. It is very difficult to come out of the all the coaches in the out who are out there. I'm not a coach, but there are a lot of coaches. I think the Netherlands have more coaches than people who live there, and it's very difficult to earn money that way. So it's a myth to say you start from today, you start a blog, and within 3 months you have 10,000 euros a month. That is not true. It costs a lot of money to be successful, to make your brand, to make advertisements, to make your the plugins. Because yesterday, again, I read on the internet said you can always start a blog. It's for free and you can make money. 59%, 95% of the bloggers never see a dime. From the 5% who does, is only 1% successful enough to live from it. So please, you can do it from home, but see it as a hobby if you start. Then you need to have the languages really well written and that sort of things. And a lot of other stuff is coming with that. And that is social media. Social media is something I really hate. I hate Facebook. I hate Instagram. It's not that I dislike it. I really hate it. So I'm very good in writing. I am very good in writing, and I'm very good in informing for the stuff I know. But I'm very bad in entertaining people on social media. So what did I do? I did outsourcing. And I don't know if you know what it is, outsourcing. Who knows what it is? Yeah. It is outsourcing. I started with about 5 months when Budget Diva really went big, and I really had to do something with social media, and I just couldn't get out of bed at 6 a.m. because I knew I had to do the social media. So this was like, oh no, not again. And now I have a virtual assistant. She lives in Kenya, and she is. I found her through. I have my own coach, because I'm not a coach, but I have a coach who helped me build my brand. And she says you have to go to freelancer, and maybe for people who are interested, it's very easy, freelancer.com. And there you can find a lot of people who are starting or very experienced in VA practices. And I found Tondi. Tondi is a Kenyan woman from 33. And she is my virtual assistant now for about 3.5-4 months. And she does everything on my social media. Even when I'm here now, through the day, I send her some pictures I made with my phone. And she makes there a very great graphic and a very great text under it. And I don't have to say anything. And every time I open my phone, yesterday and the day before, 100 reactions, 200 reactions. Stats are 40% higher since she works for me. And why we're a freelancer, I don't have the money to pay someone in the Netherlands 57 euros or 75 euros an hour for they were doing that. Tandy is very great with the opportunity for 5 euros, 3 euros an hour. She asked now 5, now she works for me, she hired her fee, but I originally hired her for $2 an hour, and now it's $3 an hour, and she works 30 hours a week, and she earns 3 times the monthly payment a nurse in Kenya gets per week. So she's very good paid for her standards, and she helps me very much. That's also something, if you go work from home, don't think you are able to do everything and you have to be an artist in everything that is required to do. Stick to your talent, and every task you get that's not in your being or is not something you can or will do, go to something like Fiverr. I understood this also something, and Upwork is also something like freelancer.
Freelance.nl
also? Yeah. I never heard of that. That's why I'm such a fan of Freelancer. Freelancer has a proof of evidence that it's a real person, and you can see the work they've done for other people, and they have rankings. When Tandy was new when I hired her, and then with some reviews and so, you can make sure that she gets more exposure on the freelancer itself. You have to have signed some documents. She also has to sign documents that is everything that I sent her from pictures or documents from me, from Budget Diva magazine. She can't go use it for someone or something else. You are protected by that. You pay only through freelancer. Don't communicate by your personal mail, only there, and you pay the freelancer by that platform, so you never get the discussion I didn't get paid or I didn't get enough or that sort of things. You are always protected. From a freelancer, 30 cents for 10. I pay 90 euros 30 cents, 90 euros per week. 90 cents go to Tandy, 30 cents go to freelancer. That's very little percentage, the fee that they get. The 30 cents is very, very, very little. I don't know. I forgot to ask her. I don't know what a freelancer asked Tandy for being at work for a fee. I don't know that. But So if you want to, 15 minutes is not a lot of time, of course, so it's almost done. So I want to have some questions from you, what you want to know about working at home that I didn't tell.
Well, I recently stopped working at home.
Yeah?
Because I found it too hard to separate my private life and my working life.
Yeah.
And as a web developer, I get support issues 24 hours a day. And they're always affecting.
Yeah. Say no. No is a powerful word. Say no to the seductions that are coming every day. My husband who asked to go shopping. My parents and parents-in-law. Do you say that, sir? Father-in-law who's coming over for visits. Say no. And what I found the first period from working was very lonely. It was very, very lonely. So try to commit yourself for one day a week, one afternoon a week, to spend time with people who are doing the same work as you, for about accountability and for some feedback. I have one girlfriend who's also a blogger, and she is a coach. I'm not, but she's a coach. And she lists 10 minutes from me away. Every Monday morning, we come together to discuss our goals and our to-do lists and that sort of thing. So that keeps you that keeps you more sane, because 24 hours a day only in the home, sitting alone in the home, is very lonely. And then you get, okay, today I'm going to write an article. Ooh, nice shoes. How much are they? You know, suddenly you are on a website for a shop with shoes. You are writing an article about... I never know how that happens, but it happens. That's something. So you have to say no. There's also the notifications from your desktop. Turn them off. It's not important that someone tweeted you with your name at that moment. That's nice when you're on the couch after dinner with a glass of wine. You can see, okay, at 8 o'clock everything is going out, and between 7 and 8 you can see who commented. But it is very hard discipline. You need the discipline to do that, because in the beginning I had these pop-ups everywhere on my desktop, everywhere. Then someone mentioned something on Facebook, and then on Instagram, and then I got mail. You got mail. I got 85 mails a day. Every time pop up, you've got mail, and something is, most of it is not relevant at all. So turn off the, and you can also, it's also important, well, for me, sometimes you need to go to the bathroom or have a cup of coffee, and I forget. I tend to forget that when I'm working very hard. So then my desktop goes black for 15 minutes. I turned it, there's a plugin for that?
A timer for that.
So then every 2 hours my computer is dead for 15 minutes. Then it's done. Then I can't do anything else. I stretch my legs and have a cup of coffee. I found her on an American Facebook group. Facebook group. I was because my coach is an American, and she added me to a Facebook group about for bloggers, and then I got a direct message from Lisa. Hey, I'm Dutch too, and I live in your neighborhood, because my hometown is on my bio. So I live in the neighborhood, and we matched. Every Monday we come together. But I can understand, and I can understand it's difficult. But if you are in a big city, it must be more easy than in the very small town I live. So I'm very lucky, I guess. I found her, but it was through a Facebook group.
So you were saying that after 8 p.m. you turn off all your devices.
Yeah.
But like, what does that have to do with your productivity?
Because I work from very, very early in the morning, and if I don't, in the beginning I worked 18 hours and I wasn't that productive anymore. And then you get your mind so full from the whole day, so very full, it doesn't have any outlet anymore. And you don't talk to your spouse anymore, or you don't have a real connection anymore. So now we are forced to look each other in the eye and remember why we fell in love with each other one day, and why we like it to live together. It's necessary to remind you of that.
But if you just like work by yourself, like I just have a room.
Yeah.
Would you recommend that too, or
is it? If you have a home phone, if you have a landline, then I recommend it to everybody. The only people who have my landline is my daughter and grandchildren and some family members. For in emergencies. Yes, Netflix. Yeah, but the television is there, and the chessboard is there, and the cards are there, the wine is there. No.
I'm going to have to interrupt you because maybe you can talk afterwards, but the next crew is already standing by to set everything up. So thank you very much for your talk.
Thank you.
In 7 minutes, Evert and Ian are talking about they checked our website and you're not going to believe. We analyzed your website and this is what you learned. So that's up for next. Also, if you haven't picked up your t-shirt yet, pick it up. If you didn't order a t-shirt, still pick one up, because we have plenty. And then, to thank you.
Thank you well. Super.
Okay, can we give her a big round of applause?
Thank you well.